I spent the last few months trying out different support structure techniques to find the best methods and tricks. Today, I'll show you what worked well and what you should avoid. From designing your own supports, breakaway filaments, to soluble support materials and an exciting trick where a layer of permanent marker is applied as a release agent. In this video, I'll cover all the tricks. So let's get right into it, here at JanTec Engineering. Thanks to PCBWay for sponsoring part of this video. Support structures are needed when the printed part has long bridges, free floating components or overhangs greater than 45 degrees. This can be seen quite clearly on this T-shaped part where the 90 degree overhangs simply fall into the void. With more modern printers that have optimized part cooling, it's often stated that the printer can print overhangs greater than 45 degrees. The point at which supports are necessary can therefore best be determined with corresponding test prints or simply by trial and error. Let's be honest, standard automatically generated support structures can often be a pain. Unfortunately, depending on the design of the component, there is often no way around them. Sometimes it can be difficult to remove supports and the risk of destroying the actual component during this attempt is also not exactly low. In addition, it can be very time consuming and the contact area between the component and the support is visible and unappealing. So there are numerous reasons to optimize the classic supports. That's why I'll show various approaches and possibilities for avoiding supports and optimizing them so that they can be removed more easily. Feel free to use the chapters in the description to navigate through the video. I'd like to start with the optimization of classic support structures using software. Thanks to the further development of slicers like Cura and Prusa Slicer, three supports were introduced. Prusa calls them organic supports. They got their name because they climb up the component like branches of a tree and support many different points. I still remember when the organic supports were first released in the new Prusa Slicer 2.6 and Twitter was full of impressive prints. The rough idea behind these kinds of supports is that the trees hold together very well and each branch has only a small contact point with the component. This means that they can usually be easily removed in one piece. The contact point also looks pretty good afterwards. I usually use organic supports with the paint-on feature in Prusa Slicer. Here it is recommended to start with the automatic painting and then block unnecessary areas. These types of supports make a lot of sense for sculptures, even though they don't solve all challenges, especially with internal supports that are difficult to reach by hand. In my opinion, the organic supports look very aesthetic and sometimes you don't even want to remove them. Especially when printed in a different color, which I did here for demonstration purposes only, the model looks beautiful. At this point, I think we should also briefly discuss the design itself. By this I mean, generally speaking, that in many cases the need for support structures can be avoided through clever design. There are various tricks, one of my favorites is this one for unsupported holes. It involves constructing 0.2mm thick bars that support the hole and prevent the printer from printing in mid-air. There are many instructions and tips on how to do this on the internet, such as this guide from Hydra Research. I've linked it in the video description. Another aspect of design is the construction of supports. I admit that this is not an easy task and requires quite a bit more experience, but it saves others who download the model a lot of work when slicing. One example are the printed parts for the Positron 3D printer. Here, all support structures are already designed into the models. This ensures that users who download the parts do not accidentally add too many or too few supports, which could ruin the geometry and look. If you want inspiration on how to design your own supports, I recommend checking out the tutorial from Desktop Makes and taking a look at the printed parts from Redrick, OpenScan and, as mentioned, Positron. If you have a printer with a multiplexing system like the MMU3 or AMS or even a tool changing printer like the Prusa XL, the supports can be printed from a different material. Even though this significantly increases printing time, it can be very useful, especially for complex geometries. In addition to soluble filaments, which I will discuss in detail in a moment, so-called breakaway supports are also an option. Some manufacturers offer special filaments for this purpose, which, as the name suggests, can be easily broken off the component. Depending on the base material, however, it's not always necessary to buy such special filament. To explore this topic in more detail, I've tested various material combinations in the past and with the help of my tensile test examined which filament types adhere to each other just poorly enough to be used as supports. The combination PLA-PTG works particularly well, meaning a PTG component with PLA supports or the other way around. The exotic material PP could also work well with PTG supports. I designed this chain for testing purposes and you can now find it with all my other test models on printables. In Prusa Slicer, I selected the soluble full option, which means that the chain is printed from PTG and the supports are printed entirely from PLA. The print went perfectly. The PLA supports were just attached well enough to the PTG part so that everything could be printed together without any problems. Removal was really easy, taking less than 30 seconds. Another advantage is that you can print the supports in a different, easily distinguishable color, like green on gray here, so you can easily identify what is support and what should be a part of the component. This also makes it easy to quickly identify and remove any small leftover. There is also the option soluble interface in Prusa Slicer, which only prints a few layers of the supporting material at the contact point with the part. Depending on the geometry, this can significantly reduce the number of tool changes and therefore the printing time. I tried this too, but unfortunately PTG and PLA stuck together too well here. I estimate that you would have to adjust the settings a bit. Before we dive into soluble support materials, I'd like to take a moment to thank the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. PCBWay is the go-to partner for bringing your ideas to life. They don't just make PCBs, they offer a full range of services including 3D printing, CNC machining, sheet metal fabrication and injection molding, all in a variety of materials. For over a decade, PCBWay has been a trusted name in the maker community because of their fast delivery times, competitive pricing and top-notch expertise. Whether you're prototyping or producing at scale, PCBWay makes it easy to turn your vision into reality. Check out PCBWay.com today and see what they can do for you. Now on to soluble support structures. This also requires a multi-material or tool-changing printer like the Prusa XL. A few months ago, I tested HIPS filament and you can find a detailed video about this filament on my channel. Since HIPS is compatible with ABS and can also be completely dissolved in limonene, it is often recommended as a support material for ASA and ABS. Of course, I tried this out and bought such a bottle of limonene on the internet. In addition to a few other test prints, I printed the model Gyro D Dodo from Virtox. It consists of 5 such nested dodecahedra that can rotate. The exciting thing about this model is that it can be made almost exclusively with soluble supports, since it's basically impossible to remove the internal supports by hand. Unfortunately, my attempts with HIPS as a support failed because the ABS also partly dissolved and became very brittle. The test model simply crumbled in my hands. You can find more details in my video about it. Another option is filament that can be dissolved in water, such as PVA or BVOH. This is very interesting at first because no special chemicals like limonene are needed. However, there are also disadvantages. The material is of course highly hygroscopic and must therefore be kept dry permanently, which can be difficult for longer prints. At first I wanted to try out BVOH, but then I got a message from the company Xionier. They make special support materials and are probably already well known in the industrial sector. Xioneer's range includes various support materials, each optimized for different material types. The supports can then be dissolved with a special support removal agent. There is a beginner set consisting of a bucket, heating rod and accessories. I think the price of around 105 euros is comparatively low because the set comes with a lot of equipment and some filament. By the way, Xioneer did not sponsor this video, but sent the materials free of charge for me to test. So I experimented a little and printed two test models out of PTG with the Xioneer VXL90 support material. Once everything looked good, it was once again time for the ultimate challenge, Gyro di Dodo. For this, I used Nobofill ABS-X again. After 19 hours of printing, I was able to remove the component from the print bed. Then I followed the instructions and first dissolved the solvent, which comes as a powder, in 10 liters of water. Then the components are placed in the bucket. This heater with integrated timer then heats the bath to the set temperature. I initially set the recommended 3 hours, but then realized that the supports had not yet been completely dissolved. So I left the components in the solution for another hour. Even though there were still some small pieces left, I finally took the parts out after about 4.5 hours and rinsed them under water. The parts looked good, but unfortunately the supports were not fully dissolved. This could be because 10 liters were not enough for all parts, since only about 180 grams of supports can be dissolved at once. My Gyro di Dodo test print still works perfectly and I'm very happy to finally have a working one. Overall, my first impressions of the Xioneer support material is good, even though the dissolving process seems a bit complicated at first. If you want me to make a detailed video about it, please let me know in the comments. Back to printers with only one nozzle, where you can simply print the supports from a different material. During my research, I found a very exciting post in the Prusa forum. The user Tumblebeer shared a modification for the Prusa i3 MK3 where a thin layer of permanent marker is applied at the interface between the support and the component. Even though it may take a little effort to equip the printer with such an extension, the findings from this project are quite interesting. I like the idea of applying a separating layer to the connecting point and I see a lot of potential also for other possible release agents. Particularly with large area supports, it can make sense to simply apply a layer of marker manually by hand. To do this, the supports are printed directly onto the component without a separation gap and the pen is applied during a print pause. This has two major advantages. The supports can be removed very easily and the contact surface, which is usually the underside, becomes very smooth and therefore dimensionally accurate. To use this trick with virtually any printer, you just have to set the top contact Z distance to 0 and right click on the slider at the desired position to insert a print pause. You can also add a custom message here. My tests worked very well. There is still a lot to try out, especially regarding different types of filaments and release agents. If you're interested, I would be happy to make a separate video about this topic. Now I would like to share a few other approaches that are worth mentioning. Firstly, there's non-planar printing. Although multi-axis printers such as the Rodbot or Open5X project are very interesting, such printers are unfortunately not yet particularly accessible. Michael Wittrich from the ZHAW School of Engineering is doing quite a bit of research in the area of non-planar printing with standard printers. For this, the E3D belt nozzles are used on printers such as the Prusa Mini or the Trilab Delta printer, along with special slicer modifications. They also recently published a paper on the topic describing how to adapt conventional toolpath generation software for use in curved layer FDM. If you're interested in this project, I recommend you to follow Michael on X and read the paper. Another approach to avoid supports are arc overhangs. For this, I recommend you to watch the video from CNC Kitchen. Feel free to share your tips and tricks in the comments and let me know what you found useful in the video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and make sure to check out my other videos.